Hello, welcome to my channel, Random Andy's channel. I appreciate you being here. If you are new here, it'd be great if you checked out my channel for the top 10s, movie reviews, and so much more other film-related content on the channel. And if you are returning, welcome back. I appreciate you as well. And it would be great if you gave this a like, subscribe, and a comment on the video down below. Let's get into the video. Hello, welcome to part one of my top 100 films of all time. If you are more of a visual aid type of person and would like to just watch a video of a list of top 100 movies with just the movie clips, I can send you to the link up above or down below in the description below. But if that's not your cup of tea and this is more your style, welcome, and let's get into part 100 through 51 of my top 100 movies of all time. At number 100, we have Steven Spielberg's Saving Private Ryan, starring Tom Hanks. This film is an incredible war film. At number 99, we have Clint Eastwood's Unforgiven, one of the last great westerns. You can't find any westerns like this today, maybe one every so often, but this was one of the last great westerns. At number 98, we have the musical Singing in the Rain, starring Gene Kelly, a great musical dance film. At number 97, we have Jim Carrey's The Truman Show, probably Jim Carrey's best performance. At number 96, we have Rebel Without a Cause, starring James Dean. At number 95, we have the musical The Phantom of the Opera, starring Gerald Butler, directed by Joel Schumacher. At number 94, we have The King's Speech, starring Colin Farrell and directed by Tom Hooper. This is a film about the king having a speech impediment and him overcoming that problem. At number 93, we have the romantic comedy Sabrina, starring the beautiful Audrey Hepburn. At number 92, we have one of my personal favorite musicals, 1776, directed by Peter Hunt, about the Declaration of Independence and how it came to be. At number 91, we have the Russo Brothers' Avengers Endgame, starring Robert Downey Jr. and so many other stars. I mean, what can I say? An incredible epic film. At number 90, we have Steven Spielberg's Lincoln, starring Daniel Day-Lewis, as his best performance as Abraham Lincoln. He becomes the role. It is fantastic. It is amazing. At number 89, we have the silent film Modern Times, starring Charlie Chaplin. At number 88, we have another silent film called The General, starring Buster Keaton. At number 87, we have Henry Fonda's Once Upon a Time in the West. At number 86, we have the almost five-hour epic The Ten Commandments, starring Charlton Heston. At number 85, we have The Lord of the Rings, The Two Towers. At number 84, we have Spartacus, the three-hour epic directed by Stanley Kubrick and starring Kirk Douglas. At number 83, we have The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly, starring Clint Eastwood and directed by Sergio Leone. At number 82, we have The Silence of the Lambs, starring Jodie Foster and Anthony Hopkins. At number 81, we have The Children of Men, directed by Alfonso Cuarón, and starring Clive Owen and Julianne Moore. If you don't know anything about this is a film about a world where women can no longer have children, and the population is dying, and there's a race for survival, and to find out the problem of why these women can no longer have children. At number 80, we have Taxi Driver with Robert De Niro and directed by Martin Scorsese. At number 79, we have Michael Mann's Heat with Al Pacino and Robert De Niro. This film is incredible, and it is really cool to see both Al Pacino and Robert De Niro on the same screen, and the diner scene is probably one of the greatest scenes of all time. At number 78, we have the great gangster film Casino, starring Robert De Niro and Joe Pesci, directed by Martin Scorsese. At number 77, we have an incredible courtroom drama starring Gregory Peck, To Kill a Mockingbird. At number 76, we have Inherit the Wind, starring Spencer Tracy and directed by Stanley Kramer. This film is from the 60s. It is based on the true story of when a man went to trial for teaching evolution in schools. At number 75, we have a very hard film to watch. It is called 12 Years a Slave, starring Chiwetel Ejiofor and directed by Steve McQueen. At number 74, we have an adorable film called Funny Face. It stars Audrey Hepburn, and it is a wonderful little musical. At number 73, we have The Last Samurai with Tom Cruise. It is a wonderful three-hour epic. At number 72, we have the courtroom drama with James Stewart, Anatomy of a Murder. At number 71, we have Alfred Hitchcock's Vertigo with James Stewart. Number 70, we have the film Misery, starring James Caan and Kathy Bates, with Kathy Bates having her greatest performance of her career here as a over-obsessed psychopathic fan of the writer she has found on the side of the road who has crashed, and she brings him in to take care of him. And chaos ensues after that. At number 69, we have Quentin Tarantino's Pulp Fiction, starring John Travolta and Samuel L. Jackson. At number 68, we have The Matrix, starring Keanu Reeves and directed by the Wachowskis. At number 67, we have Miles Forman's One Flew Over the Cuckoo Nest, starring Jack Nicholson. At number 66, we have the great horror film starring Jack Nicholson, The Shining, directed by Stanley Kubrick. At number 65, we have Daniel Day-Lewis, There Will Be Blood. At number 64, we have Young Mr. Lincoln with Henry Fonda, another great film about Abraham Lincoln, and Henry Fonda is amazing in this film. At number 63, we have Greta Gerwig's Little Women. And what I love about Little Women is how they integrate the color tone for presenting the past and the present, where the present is a grayish tone and the past is presented in a very gorgeous orange, colorful tone. At number 62, we have 2014's Birdman. At number 61, we have Alfred Hitchcock's Psycho. At number 60, we have Witness for the Prosecution. At number 59, we have The Shawshank Redemption. At number 58, we have The Departed. At number 57, we have The Dark Knight. At number 56, we have Robert Downey Jr.'s greatest performance as Chaplin in Chaplin. At number 55, we have 1917, a fantastic one-shot, one-take film that is made to look like a one-take one-shot. It is fantastic. At number 54, we have The Lord of the Rings, The Return of the King. At number 53, we have The Adventures of Robin Hood. At number 52, we have The Untouchables. And at 51, we have Inside Out. And that was part one of two of my top 100 movies of all time. Again, if you're more of a visual aid person, the link is above and below in the description below for that top 100 video. And if this is more your taste, stay tuned for part two. And if this video has already been posted for a while, you can click the link above for part two. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for being here. I appreciate it. If you are a new subscriber, I appreciate you for subscribing. If you have not subscribed yet, I would appreciate it if you did. And click the bell to get notified of future videos, as well as for my subscribers who have been with me for a while. I appreciate you guys being here. Thank you for watching the video, commenting down below, and stay random, guys.